this. So we just looked at the bottomless pit situation. Now we have to figure out, well, what is the name of this beast? It's very, very simple. We know that the beast is a king, okay? From the spiritual dimensions of the bottomless pit. When we get to Revelation 9, it says here, it actually talks about Apollyon. And he's, what is he called? The angel of the bottomless pit. He's an angel like Lucifer. And he's a king. Remember, in Revelation 17, the beast is a king. He's the eighth king. Well, Apollyon is the king over the locusts. So remember that? King. Apollyon's a king as well. He's a king over the locusts of the bottomless pits. Abaddon's another name for him. It just means destroyer. He's a destroying angel. Lucifer, although he's obviously a murderer as well, his stuff is mainly through, you know, he's like the father of lies. Deception is his main speciality. That's what Lucifer's, that's what the dragon's speciality is mainly in, is mainly deception. So anyway, now when we get to Revelation 13, we have to read this, we have to understand the symbology, we have to understand the symbolic nature of what's actually going on here. And this is where the tricky part comes in. But it's okay, because the key word we have to be aware of is the word given. The spiritual beast needs a physical king to work through. So, right, this is me helping you understand that. So it says here, for example, that that he was given a mouth speaking great things and blasphemies. Right, that's the mouth of the Antichrist, okay? He was given a physical mouth. How does he get that physical mouth? He gets it from the Antichrist king, the seventh king. Yeah? From whatever this kingdom is. The beast was given a mouth, you know, so when you read through Revelation 13, you'll notice the word given. He was given this, he was given that. He was given this continually. He was given power over the saints. How does he get power over the saints? Through the king of the north. He's the seventh king, you know, that eventually causes strife amongst the Christians. So that's how you read it. It says, and he was given power over tongues, nations, etc. How does he get that power? Because he's been given the physical king, the Antichrist. So because the Antichrist has world dominion, then he ends up having world dominion too, because he's possessing the Antichrist. That's why the scriptures keep saying given, he was given. If the beast was the Antichrist, the word given shouldn't even be there. Because he would end up just doing it all by himself, wouldn't he? But no, he has to be given a physical king because he's in a spiritual dimension. He can't just do things. He can't just control a kingdom without there being a king to control, which is the Antichrist. All right? So that's how you need to read Revelation 13. Okay, now we're going to delve into Mary Baxter's work. This is where things get very interesting. This is when she goes to hell with Jesus, okay? I've been following her work for a long time. There's no chance she's making these things up. Through my own analysis, right, you know, I'm convinced that she really did go to hell with Jesus and really did see these things happening. This is what she says, anyway, concerning Daniel about the 10 horns, okay, which are the 10 kings, and kings, of course, rule over kingdoms. She says here, Jesus touched me, did strengthen me, we walked on. Ahead I saw a large black, so this is her in hell. You can read her book online. And she says, and I saw a large black object, almost as big as a baseball field, which seemed to be moving up and down. I remember that I had been told this was the heart of hell, okay. And she says, in amazement, I looked at this evil heart and wondered what was its purpose, okay? Jesus said, these branches, so there's like branches and arteries growing out of it, you know, going up to the surface of the earth, which look like arteries of a heart, are pipelines that go up through the earth to spill out evil upon it. Okay, so I'll be able to explain eventually further on what's going on here. These are the horns that Daniel saw. And they represent evil kingdoms on the earth. So these are the horns from the beast. This fourth kingdom, Rome. That's what it's talking about here. Evil kingdoms will arise, he says. You'll notice he doesn't say a kingdom. It doesn't say kings with, somehow connected to Rome. He's just saying evil kingdoms will arise. Okay? And he says here, evil kingdoms on the earth, some have already been, some shall be, and some are now. Okay? Evil kingdoms will arise, and the Antichrist will rule over many peoples, places, and things. Okay? Now, Jesus is using our language of the Antichrist, because I know that it means in place of Christ. That doesn't necessarily mean it's the King of the North, but in this context here, we understand the Antichrist as the one that has the mouth speaking great things and blasphemies, and we understand him as being the king of the North in Daniel 11. And he says here, if possible, the very elect will be deceived by him. So the Antichrist will rule over many peoples, places, and things, and if possible, the very elect will be deceived by him. Many will turn away and will worship the beast and his image. So they're going to be worshipping a spiritual beast, which is Apollyon, and they will worship his image. Now, Apollyon or Apollo was a sun god, worshipped in ancient times as a type of supreme being. Okay? Like the creator of everything. The ancients perceived him as the creator of everything. And they would call the sun the eye. Like all seeing, like Helios is a sun god, another form of Apollyon, called all seeing. That's what he was called. Yeah? So it's like the sun is the eye is the sun. It's like in Hinduism, Surya was called the all seeing eye of the universe. I think that was correct, but it was to do with being able to see everything. Like the sun god as being an eye at the same time that can see everything. That's why in Freemasonry you will sometimes see an eye with sun rays coming from it, like an all-seeing eye of Freemasonry. It's not the all-seeing eye of Lucifer. It's the all-seeing eye of Apollyon. Tom Horne talks about that. He goes into details on that. So and also it says here, and out of these main branches or horns, smaller branches will grow. Out of the smaller branches will come demons, evil spirits, and all manner of evil forces. They will be released upon the earth and instructed by Satan to do many evil works, okay? I'll be exposing the evil works in this world system today. Well, not today, but at some point, right, in my later videos. And it says here, these kingdoms and evil forces will obey the beast, and many will follow him to destruction. Right? So that we know that the beast is connected to Rome. So it means that these, basically what's going on here is that these kingdoms are gonna be traced. They're gonna be connected to Rome. That's why we've got the interfaith or bringing all religions together, practiced by the Catholic Church, the Vatican of Rome. Yeah, like Pope Francis trying to bring all the religions together, and then talking about things like one world government. That's like one world leader. Basically, that idea, which will eventually be the Antichrist, that idea comes from the Jesuits as well. And of course, it all gets traced back to Rome, which is where this fourth kingdom is upon the earth. This goes to the world, obey the beast, and it is here in heart of hell that these things begin. So the things in Revelations, the evil things in Revelations, okay, it all starts in hell first, okay? So that's what's going on. And I'm gonna end this video, and I'm gonna eventually talk on the four horsemen of the apocalypse, to help you just understand what's going on there as well. And bye for now.